All right, this video is about how to tell if your thermostat is bad. First thing you're going to want to do is you're going to want to pull apart right here on your thermostat, open up the face, all right? So I'm assuming that this LCD display would be lit up, but we're not able to turn the fan on, we're not able to turn the heat on, we're not able to turn the cooling on. So you have red is your 24 to 28 volt power wire coming in, and then it goes back out either the white, yellow, or a green wire, depending on what you're telling it to do. The thermostat, when telling the fan to turn on, the 24 volts will be coming in the red and coming back out the G. If it was coming in as red and going back out as the Y, that would be for cooling. 24 volts coming in for red, and if we turn the heat on, it would come back out the white wire, and it would go to the furnace control board in order to tell it what to do. Okay, so these are your signal wires. So what we really need to do here is to determine if the fan is going to turn on. We could take the display and the control board out of play a couple of different ways. You could take a thermostat wire like this, strip both ends, and you could use it as a jumper. All right, so you can pull this faceplate off, this 24 volt faceplate, while the furnace is on or the air handler is on. All right, it's 24 volts and all this is signal wires. The only way that you could short out the thermostat wires would be by connecting the red and the blue wire together. That would short out the transformer in the furnace, or short out the fuse protecting the transformer in the furnace. All right, so just leave them alone. And if you don't even have a common, because you have batteries in your thermostat, you know, then there's nothing to short it out against right there, unless you hit a common somewhere else. All right, or ground. So you have 24 volts in the R, okay? And you're gonna connect that over to the G. If when you do this and you put, you know, pressure on it, you wanna make sure your fingers are safe and not touching the electrodes there. But if that turns the fan on, then you know that this faceplate is bad, okay? And that the terminal board back here is still good, all right? But if you wanted to take this out of play, we could go about that as well. If you didn't have a jumper like this, you could even take some pair of needle nose, okay? You could go from here to here, all right, and jump it out that way. You could jump it out with a set of jumper wires, you know? You could push this in here and this in here, just make sure that they're smaller than the opening, okay? And that would jump it out as well. All right. In this case, since we're going to pull the wires out, we're going to actually take this out of play, I would suggest then go ahead and turn your furnace or air handler off, all right, before you go touching any of these wires and pulling them out. Turn the furnace off, confirm that it's off. Then you're going to go ahead and turn your screw counterclockwise and pull your red wire out. I always like to start with the green wire, you know, because it just turns the fan on. If you were to try to jump the Y and the red out, then there would be no 5 minute on delay to keep the compressor safe. So if you were to turn these on and the compressor turned on, and then you turned the compressor off and then immediately turned it back on again, that will do damage to the compressor, and you don't want to do that. All right, so in the thermostat here, there's a 5 minute on delay between when you've turned the compressor off and when you turn it back on again. Just to keep the compressor safe, all right? But anyway, so if you just connect the red and the G wires together, we can connect them with alligator clips. Or if you don't have that, just a simple wire nut will do. You can connect it like this, or you could wire nut them together like this. All right. Now you go ahead and turn your furnace back on. You see that? Turn your furnace back on and see if the fan turns on. All right. If it does not turn on, then your problem's back at your furnace. All right. So that's how you would do it. All right. If you wanted to turn the power back off to your furnace and wire nut the R and the white wire together to see if your heat will turn on, the sequence of operation of your heat will turn on, then you can do that too. I would just be careful with, make sure your furnace is off, first of all. I would be careful with maybe touching this to the yellow wire, because you don't want to do damage to that compressor, because it's going to have low pressure refrigerant on one side, high pressure refrigerant on the other side, and it's going to have a heck of a time trying to turn back on if it hasn't been given a chance to equalize those refrigerants. So the simplest thing is to just connect the red and the G together. All right, so that's it. That's how you tell if your thermostat is bad. If the fan does come on, then you just need to replace this thermostat. All right, but as I've said before, just make sure your power is off while you're doing it. All right, hope you had a good time, and see you next time at acservicetech.com.